Studios. This is WOCA, Ocala, Gainesville, The Villages, 1370 AM, 96.3 FM, The Source.
Spooky music.
That is creepy.
Because it's Halloween.
It's Halloween. Early. early Halloween.
Dr. Terror Eyes is in the studio. You don't look like Dr. Terror Eyes right now, though.
No, I sure don't.
Dr. William Ramsey is in the studio, and Terror Eyes is a great, clever name because you are an eye doctor, so Terror Eyes.
Yeah.
Very cool.
Worked out.
And your costume is unbelievable. It's an award-winning costume you've created, right? Have you won, like, prizes for your character, right?
Oh, yeah.
So Halloween is like a huge deal for you, right?
It sure is. You know, I've been doing this Halloween stuff for about 44 years now, and it's just part of my life, and my wife and kids kind of tolerate it.
But you don't I think I had this conversation with you once before. You don't ever, you don't buy into necessarily the real hauntings, or do you? Am I wrong about that?
You mean like spiritual hauntings?
Yeah,
and
like
things?
You know what people say, like Seven Sisters Inn, for example. They'll say there's a ghost that lives in there, right. And people say they see it or hear it or something like that.
Well, certainly, I have the belief there is an afterlife of some kind, and there are hauntings. I know enough people that look into do ghost hunting. They use devices, and they look. I look for objective data, which is what devices measure. And there's got to be something out there. What it is, I don't know. I haven't had a really, a ghost coming to me. But I've had a medium come up to me and knew that my sister had passed away a long time ago.
Oh, really?
And had said things that she would and I would know.
Oh my god.
So there's something there. And so, my wife has experienced things a few times, getting touched and pushed and things. Yeah.
Do you think messing with it in the playful way that you do scares people?
Well, Halloween is different from the paranormal, but there's an overlap.
Yeah.
So When I do all my Halloween stuff, we're having fun, we're celebrating Halloween and the season and witches and ghosts and skeletons and scary things. But then there's that aspect of things that go bump in the night that we don't know about, to understand.
Yeah. Yeah.
And that's what ghost hunting and such is all about. That's the paranormal, spiritual. And there is a person here in town that does the ghost tours downtown, which we can talk about
was
that later.
Catherine?
Yeah, Catherine. Yeah.
We love Catherine. Yeah.
Catherine does her ghost walk downtown and takes you to places in Ocala that are supposedly haunted and that where she can relate to spirits.
I have an open mind about it. I've heard Catherine talk, and I've heard other people who do the similar things. I'm guessing that they've seen things that I haven't seen or heard things that I haven't heard, and I'm guessing there must be something to it. What do I know? But you have fun with it. You do. It's almost like you're a walking theme park in a way. you can bring a theme park to somebody's home.
I can appreciate that. There's theme parks. You've got Disney has their set up at Halloween time, but you've got Halloween Horror Nights over at Universal Studios, which is just...
Have you ever gone to that?
Yes, in the past. I've also been to Howl's Scream at Busch Gardens.
Okay.
You have to go there with an understanding there's a push to go through quickly. And you can't look around. Like, I appreciate details and props and scenes.
Yeah. Right.
And they want to kind of get you through pretty quickly because there's a volume of other people behind you. And you have to get... So I like it. And I like haunted houses where you pay money to go in there also.
Right.
But I like to take my time. And the actors are great. The scares are creepy. But I like that thing over there that they made. And how did they make that? You know, so.
Do you know what? I went through a haunted house once in Daytona. And it was kind of on the low budget end, and so you kind of knew, this is fake, everything's fake, of course, but the only thing that actually scared me was a balcony. because you're supposed to go to the balcony and look down and see the ghosts.
Right.
Okay, so you go on the balcony, and then you look down, and you can see these ghosts, okay? And then the balcony drops like 3 inches. And I thought, really, I was going to fall. I thought the whole thing was collapsing. And so that was the real, I really got And it turned out it was just a little device or something that somebody pushes a button and you fall down.
It's a quick drop.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Fear, you know, fear of heights. That's quite common.
Yeah.
Public speaking, heights, a lot of things.
So the listener who doesn't know what you do needs to know why we're talking about Halloween on June 8th.
Sure.
So why are you doing that? Why are we talking Halloween today? Mm-hmm.
A quick synopsis. The last 8 years previous to this, I've hosted the Florida Haunters Group, which is a group now of about 1,000 people from around the state of Florida. Last year, I did it, and we had grown so much, we kind of shut down the air conditioning system at the venue. They couldn't keep up with us. It got hot.
What?
I lost count at 125 people. And I'm like, that's it. We can't do it here anymore. It's too small. And that was at the Masonic Lodge here in town.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
So I started looking around, and now...
Where they have great fish on Fridays, by the way.
Yeah, that's right. Do. That's right. Thank you. Yes. So this year, I found a venue that's much larger. It's several thousand square feet. And I decided to kick it up a notch and bring in speakers from around the state that are very skilled and very knowledgeable in Halloween and scaring people. And they've got some people coming with backgrounds at Halloween Horror Nights at Universal Disney and the Tampa Zoo. So we've got some great speakers coming, and we also have a paranormal section of the event. So I've taken an event that was a few hours, well, actually it was all day, to a two-day event. Brought in paranormal, brought in some outstanding speakers from around the state, and we're offering, we had 35 things to do, 35 courses, plus a kids area, and last time I had 5 or 6 things to do, so we've sixfold. Just enormous amount of fun things to do and learn about Halloween, paranormal, and get you in the spirit.
So there are certain things like the skull that you have on the desk.
Oh, yeah.
Here. Does that come apart?
Yeah, this is a Harvey skull. And actually, he's part of a whole skeleton I have in my car.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I'm going to be teaching a class on how to take
a
bony white skeleton. Yeah. Don't have a wreck. A bony white skeleton and make him all corpsed up and ugly and brown and decaying. Kind of like something you'd see from a scary movie, maybe. And we'll take that, and I'll teach you how to do that. I've got a class, and in 45 minutes, we corpse up an entire skeleton and make it look ugly and scary.
Oh, wonderful.
Yeah, something like Indiana Jones. That does.
And what materials do you use to make the body?
That's the secret. Oh, the body's already made. I have a whole skeleton, medical skeleton.
So what's the secret part, the clothing?
So make it look all, it looks like it's an old
brown
shriveled
up. What do you mean the body's already
up.
Made?
Huh?
You say you have a skeleton.
A white skeleton.
Right.
But it's not scary. A white skeleton, everybody sees, and they're like, eh. But you want to have a corpsey-looking... Remember the skull I brought in last year, that ugly brown?
Right, yeah.
The whole body is like that. Well, this guy's face will be like that.
Okay.
His whole body is brown and gnarly. And
that stuff is a secret.
And that's not a secret. That's something I share.
Yeah, that is something you teach, right?
Oh, yeah. I teach it to 4 people. I get 4 volunteers, and we knock it out in 45 minutes.
Nice. Well, you had the corpse bride in your office, and I took a picture of you next to that corpse bride.
Right.
Oh, yeah,
and
right,
that's
yeah.
what it looked like.
That yeah, and then you moved out of that office. Yeah. What happened?
Let's see.
Did you get scared?
I was at Lang's office.
Yeah, right across the street.
And it was sold out to my eye doctor. I was with that company for a while.
And then
I ended up getting a nice job offer down in the Villages. So
that's where you are now?
So I'm no longer in Ocala. I'm down in the Villages. Uh-huh. Oh, okay. Yeah.
And is that an easier group of people to scare?
Villages? No, they all enjoy it. I mean, everybody. I dressed up the dilation area and the office this year also, so it was the same kind of thing. People came in and had fun and sat with my skeletons.
How far in advance do you have to get people to sign up for your annual event?
I was saying earlier, this is an 8th year, and then it's transformed into this bigger show. So now it's actually a fundraiser. It's a charitable fundraiser for the Tampa Shriners Children's Hospital.
Oh, nice.
Oh, nice.
And so a good portion of the proceeds are going to help with, because I'm a Mason, and all Shriners are Masons,
right.
And I like the Shriners Hospitals and the one in Tampa. I said I'll delegate some money to them. So as far as the show, we have tickets online. Everything is online at our website. We call it CHEC. My wife and I are like, what do we call this thing? Because it's Southeastern Halloween Enthusiast Convention. We said, CHEC. That sounds good.
S-E-H-E-C.
Yeah. Okay. But if you go to SEHEC.com, that's everything. The website's there. Tickets, times, dates. All the phenomenal presenters. There's like 34 of them, I think, we've got. Mm-hmm. Just huge number. And it's all in fun. And it's got a costume ball and classes upon classes. We've had a really cool class that if you want to have a skeleton in your front yard standing there with a shovel, acting like he's sticking his foot in the ground and digging up a hole like this, we've got that prop. You can actually make all the mechanical parts. You just have to add the skeleton and a shovel. But it's all the armatures and everything for the skeleton to stand on and make him look like he's doing this shovel and digging in your yard.
So you can teach a person how to do that.
Right. We have Ant Patron, who makes some phenomenal Halloween project props, and he's going to be doing a couple classes. And that class is so simple. We also have one that's great for kids. It's a waving skeleton stuck in an urn, and he's waving his hand around and reaching out kind of.
Oh, how cool.
He's teaching that class, too. And we limit those classes to 10 people because we want to get it done in an hour and a half and get personal attention. Make sure you understand the prop and how you're making it. And you go home with something cool to stick in your yard or your house, whatever. Fun stuff.
And this is really nice because in years past you offered this class, and like you said, it has grown so much. And now you're turning it into a fundraising event. But this is so beneficial for the people that love to have fun on Halloween. Right. And it's so rewarding to be able to make something yourself than to just buy it from the store.
Exactly. I mean, everybody can go to Walmart. You can go there's a certain spirit store here in town and places like that, and you can buy pre-done things, and that's fine and dandy. If you want something quick and easy, okay. But if you want to get one of those and doctor it up or make something totally different, we talk all about that. We have got classes upon classes all day long. Actually, we have a couple of famous people. We got Kyle Vest, who was on the
that was the
Body
guy in
Wars.
This picture right here, right?
Yeah, Kyle Vest is on the website. Yeah, he was
him?
Skin Wars last year.
Uh-huh.
And Skin Wars, not last year, but a few years ago, but it's an airbrushing a class that he's going to offer. He's a professional airbrush artist. And you can go one-on-one with a guy that's Hollywood class kind of airbrush, and he'll teach you how to do that in a small classroom with a few people, and they'll teach you all that. And you see some of his work from last year. He was here last year and did a little demonstration. Everybody loved it and said, my God, can you bring him back? And Kyle said, sure. And so now he's doing a private class.
And this is really nice because you have all those different classes, and somebody might be interested in doing one thing, but they don't want to do something else. So you're able to run the gamut with the people's interests.
Exactly. We also have the paranormal section because let's say the husband wants to learn how to do airbrushing, but the wife says, you know, I want to learn something that's a little more fun, like for my parties. Well, we've actually got a paranormal medium thing, so women love to go to that and get their spiritual reading, and then they can learn about chocolate and chocolate desserts and how to make them for a Halloween party. We've got Chef Bloom, who is a phenomenal chocolate, I call him a specialist, but a chocolatier, and he'll be teaching the history of chocolate and show you how to take it from the tree all the way to making chocolates and phenomenal chocolates like you've never tasted. I mean, it's just it's not bastardized like the stuff you buy at the stores. Unfortunately, there's a huge difference between the candy bars you buy at the store and real chocolate.
Oh, my God.
Really? So if I gave you a Hershey bar, you would say, this is bastardized.
once you understand the differences and watch, you come to the class, you can watch them make it, the whole process, and you go, oh, my God, and try it. It's like, I'll never eat a candy bar again.
Let me ask you about the ambiance around everything, because you create the skeletons and all the scary stuff, right?
Sure.
So there's three other things that I always notice in a haunted house. There's the music, there's like the smoke, and there's often a scent that happens. Can you help me understand? The music is easy to understand, although maybe not. Maybe there's more to it than I know. Can you talk about the things that create the ambiance around all those things?
Well, sure. When you have somebody...
And I guess there's lighting also. That would be a fourth thing, yeah. Right?
It's like when you have someone come into your house, your haunt, your yard haunt, a commercial haunt like Halloween Horror Nights, you have to work in as many senses on somebody as you can. Uh-huh. If you overload your senses... they're going to lose it and just freak out, and that's what you want. So you want to have them pee in their pants. That's what you want. You're looking for that. So we use scented sprays and devices that spray off smells, and they've got smells, everything from cotton candy in a clown-themed haunt to some dead, rotten, corpsey stuff.
Really?
There's also fog, and we also have... A haze, there's a hazer device which gives you a real fine mist like smoke, like
really?
Cigarette smoke. So that gives you that cloudy vision, and I want to know it's over there, but I can't quite see it kind of thing.
Yeah.
Lighting is always important. You know, there's now we use LEDs that are so small. You know, back in the day, 10 years ago, I've got these big, huge studio lights that are huge. Heat lamps almost. Now these little LEDs are the size of your fingertip and do the same light. It's just phenomenal.
And it's interesting if the light aims at you or it aims away from you. Sometimes I'll be in these places and the light is in my eyes intentionally to make it difficult to see something that's going to happen next.
Sure, it depends on the effect we're looking for.
Yeah,
and sound is all part of that too. You know, when you get into an area where there's a swamp, you want to hear the crickets and the frogs and all that, not just walk into a room and there's nothing really there. It doesn't, your mind doesn't buy into the whole thing.
Right.
But the more you add that reality, you know, the humidity and things, it all starts to make your mind go, this is real. Or it could be real.
Does storytelling ever play a role in any of the haunts? Maybe somebody like with Vincent, what's the guy's name? Vincent Peale?
Yes.
Vincent Price?
Vincent Price. Thank you.
Oh, yeah.
I was thinking Norman Vincent Peale.
Certainly.
Yeah, Vincent Price. Yeah, he would have this delivered. Joe Martone could do it if he wanted to, that kind of a voice, right?
Oh, sure. And, you know, the whole thing in doing a Halloween scene or a haunted house is a theme, and you want to work off of that theme. You decide on what it is you want to do. Do you want to have clowns? Okay, if you have clowns, let's stick them in the middle of a swamp. You know, make it tie together, make a story out of it. And like in Halloween Horror Nights, you might go to a theme, and that year it might be the movie It. And that clown, that creepy clown with the big snarly teeth,
he may be
in different places and scenes from that movie that you walk through that bring you back into that movie and that feeling of horror. So it all, there's a theme. And that's part of the classes we have. We've got speakers like Scott Swenson and Robbie LaPree, who are all phenomenal people in the haunt industry, and they help you give the average person how to make your house not just a chop shop of just junk. You know,
sure.
A bloody hand here, a skeleton there, and a clown over here. What? You want to get some kind of a theme, and that's what they help you do, is these folks help you tie these things together so you have an idea.
I think you are single-handedly influencing Halloween in Ocala, by the way, because it seems like every year there are more people who've got these really elaborate lawns. The front lawn is set up so that the kids who are going up to the door. The one that worries me the most is the guy who tries to do what you're talking about, and the answer to his question, how can I scare the kids, is I'm going to dress up like I'm a scarecrow, and I'm going to sit on the front porch, and then I'm going to stand up when they come on the porch.
Yep.
It's like an easy, easy. It's
That's
an easy
a simple
one.
And effective thing.
Yeah.
It's
yeah.
Real simple, yeah. I did that when I was a kid.
Yeah.
When I was 14, I was doing that.
By the way, you know it's illegal to scare the Queen if she's in Canada.
No, I didn't know that. I didn't know that.
We had this funny thing about Canadian laws yesterday. Mm-hmm. And if the Queen's in Canada and you scare her, you're going to be arrested.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. Do you also teach people how to not overdo something?
I'm not an actor teacher by any means.
Mm-hmm.
I have my own style of things I do with my character, but there are plenty of people who will be there at the event teaching people, you know, there's ways you do things, there's ways you scare people, there's certain things you do say and don't say, and things you don't do. And one of the creepiest lines I just read the other day in one of our haunt posts was when a guy came up to somebody, and he'd walk up to you in his outfit in the middle of this scary haunt and go, "You smell different when you're awake."
Oh.
Okay, that's got two creepy
that's
levels
creepy.
Right there.
Oh, yeah.
I told my wife that, and she said, oh, no. Anyway, so there's things you say and do in a haunt, and I'm not the guy to go to for that. The specialist will be there at the
you
show
know,
for that.
Before we went on the air, Robin, you weren't in the room, but we were talking about the video that we made. The doctor was talking about the thing you and I made.
Yes.
The haunted mansion thing that Robin and I made was called It's Only Pretend. And our audience is a children's audience when we're not doing this. Well, when we back in the day. Anyway, so the whole point of that was to make it look fun with the constant reminder that it's only pretend. Robin is the know-it-all. No, she knows what's going on, and I'm the one who's like scared of all these little things. And she says, "Don't worry, it's only pretend." And that's the message at the end, right?
Yep.
When you saw the video, you probably thought, "Oh my God, this is amateur." Have you ever tried to make a video where it was exactly the opposite, where it was intended to scare people?
Have I made a video to scare? No, but
I mean, with your character, you have this amazing character.
Yeah, I do that, but I don't do a video about how to do that. Now, last year, you asked me about Dr. Terror Eyes and the backstory, and you said, wouldn't that be good for a movie or something or a book or a story?
Yes.
Well, I've been working on a book
for
about a year now, and a playwright thing. I've been writing a
screenplay.
Nice.
So
I've got things in the works for Dr. Terror Eyes.
Oh, good. We'll hook up with somebody who knows how to do it.
Oh, yeah.
What other things can we expect when we go?
Well, we've got... In the paranormal, if someone's interested in spirits and such, there's a class that has a paranormal specialist. These are people that do ghost hunting and are mediums, and they talk about things you can do to go out and do these ghost hunting devices. We've also have a theme park panel where people that have worked at Disney, Universal, Legoland, Busch Gardens, and they're going to talk about what these theme parks do on a large scale. And then there's another class that tells you how to maybe take some of these ideas and bring them to a smaller scale for your home or your yard.
Oh.
So you can say, God, it's just huge. How can I even start doing something? No, there's a guy that helps. Okay, let's bring it down into perspective and scale. And they teach you that. And we've got, I don't know, five or six classes with props you can make. We've got making prosthetic wounds. We've got making eyeballs, making a rose with an eyeball in it. A lead pipe, a weapon that's made out of PVC pipe. So, you know, The Walking Dead was the big zombie movie. Well, it shows you how to make this PVC pipe. Looks like it's a real lead pipe that you swing and hit a zombie with. It's got blood and hair on it and everything, yeah.
Oh, wow.
Don't walk around that with the police. They'll see that.
And that's your one of your specialties, because you're an award-winning prop builder. I mean, you do amazing things.
But I'm not. The only thing I'm doing is corpsing that entire skeleton guy. His name is Harvey, by the way. Harvey will be there and... he's one of our
guys. When you've done the this kind of seminar in the past, you've encouraged people to they had a list of materials that they needed to buy for a special class, and then they would bring it with them. Yeah. Is it the same this year?
Nope. This year, everything's provided. When you pay your class fee, that covers the cost of the goods.
Mm-hmm. And how much is it?
So it's covered. Excuse me?
How much is it?
It depends on the class. Some classes are more than others. Some are maybe 15 or 20. Some maybe 65, because there's more motors and electronics involved.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
It just depends on... So each make and take class has got its own price on the website.
So this is all happening here in Ocala.
It's all in Ocala.
July 14th and 15th.
Right across from Hobby Lobby, actually, on 200.
Okay, so the 14th and 15th.
Yep.
And what is the building called?
The building is the Early Learning Coalition's building.
Oh, okay.
Oh, okay.
And we're taking it over those couple of days and changing it up and making it very scary and fun.
Haunting Coalition.
And we've got three classrooms going, plus a kids area. We also have, for any kid that's 12 and under, it's free admission. And they get two toys coming in that are worth about $20. And then if they want to make some props, we have some kids' props they can make.
Oh.
And they're like $10 to get three of them. And so that's fun, too.
Yeah. How cool is that?
Yeah. Do you know, I was trying to think of something here. The International House of Pancakes is changing their name to IHOB instead of P. So everybody's trying to guess what the new initials will stand for. Maybe it's the International Haunted Old
Bacon.
Yeah, 100 old bodies.
I didn't hear that. Really? They're changing the name?
Yeah, yeah. But they haven't let on yet what the B will stand for.
Breakfast.
That's what everybody's guessing.
Yeah.
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 But I'm thinking maybe the other letters will change. You know, I'm going to say, I'll have only bacon. Or I'll have only burgers or something.
Well, you have sections of the building set up like it's a real haunted house?
It's not like a walk-through haunted house you would go to and get scared and spooky. We don't have that kind of room or luxury to do that at this year. Maybe next year I have another venue picked out this much larger even. So when you go in, there will be some atmospheric stuff going on. But we've got booths. We have vendors with some nice big booths. All kinds of scary stuff you can buy right there at the show. So it's fun stuff.
So, well, that's pretty amazing.
So go to the website. What was it again? The website?
SEHEC.com. We call it CHEC.
SEHEC.com. That's where I went.
Yeah.
And then you will be prepared for Halloween. Even though it's only June 8th, you'll be so set up. Your neighbors will want to get their neighbors to come over and check out what you've got going
on. Have a scary time.
Yeah. I always wanted to be like in a haunted house. Like, I want to be the guy who says, there's something in your future. And they go, are you a medium? And I say, I'm an extra large.
Ba-da-boom.
Hey, thank you. Dr. William Ramsey, also known as Dr. Terror Eyes, thank you for coming in here and sharing. It's always fun when you're here.
Sure. It's always great being here. Thank you, Larry. Thank you, Robin.
You're welcome.
We'll be right back.
Are thinking about selling your home, but where do you start? Easy. Call Angie at 352-361-8359. Angie works with you to get your home sold. Angie is more than just an agent with Roberts Real Estate. She's a pro with heart. Call her.